So then the guy says, well, you better tickle mine, too, because now I got to catch the goddamn thing.
Cheers. Mm.
To a job? Well done.
Yeah.
Are you going to join us, darling?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, the map proves it. Drake didn't screw around in the East Indies for 6 months. He sailed straight through and headed to Arabia.
Right.
But here's where it gets interesting. You see this mark? This is John D's signature.
Who the hell's John D?
John D, one of Queen Elizabeth's closest advisors. Everybody knows that.
Yeah, yeah, he was a great mathematician and navigator. Okay, way ahead of his time. He's probably the one who invented that.
Seriously into the occult. I mean, like a really creepy dark
way. See, he signed all his letters to the Queen with this symbol, meaning he was her eyes.
The original 007, you see, look, 007.
Not really that relevant.
So it was John D who sent Drake to Arabia.
Yeah, it looks that way. D and Elizabeth.
And Walsingham.
Great, but what for?
Well, that's the million-dollar question, isn't it? And this is where T.E. Lawrence comes in. See, before Lawrence became Lawrence of Arabia...
Great film.
He was an archaeologist. And even when he was just a kid, he was obsessed with history. Everything to do with knights and the Crusades. And he traveled all over, documenting every Crusader site he could find. It's all in here.
All right, you've lost me completely, kid. What the hell has this got to do with Drake?
I'm getting to that. See, after the war, Lawrence said that if he were ever to go back to Arabia, it would be to search for this place he called the Atlantis of the Sands. Now, the legend crops up over and over again under different names. Ubar, Aram of the Pillars, the City of Brass. But the story is always the same.
Well, city of immeasurable wealth, destroyed by God for its arrogance, swallowed forever in the sands of the Rubalkali Desert.
Right here.
Well, I like the immeasurable wealth part anyway.
And you think this is what Elizabeth and Dee sent Drake after?
Oh, yeah. And more importantly, it's what Marlowe is after.
So, wait, if Drake was on a mission from the Queen to find this place, why all the secrecy? I mean, it looks like he went to a lot of trouble to hide whatever he found, even from Her Majesty.
I don't know.
Oh, I'm sorry, what was that?
No, hang on a second, because if you recall, the last time we went halfway around the world searching for a lost city, things got more than a little dicey.
Yeah, but this time we have the upper hand. I mean, look, Drake only had half the clues. Lawrence only had half. We have both. And Marlowe has nothing.
Small problem. The Rubalkali Desert, 600 miles across. The Bedouin go around the damn thing.
And even if we knew where it was, which we don't, we would die trying to find
just
it.
Just hold on. You see these symbols here?
Yeah. Looks like Sabaean script.
Sabaean script. Right. Look, the Crusaders were searching for the same lost city 1,000 years ago. But out of all the sites Lawrence documented, only two are marked with these symbols. One in Syria, the other in France. No, you two are going to Syria. We're heading to France. Look, we track down these clues. We find Lawrence's lost city. I'm sure of it.
Well, and then what? How are we going to get across 600 miles of impassable wasteland?
Well, it's in the middle of the desert. So technically, it'd be about 300 miles. Look, I don't know. We'll figure it out.
We burn that bridge when we get to it, eh?
Exactly. What do you say?
What the hell?
Let's do it.
And so a new adventure begins. And we're back into another jungle, just like every single Uncharted game. That's fine.
Don't. Looks like we're going the rest of the way on foot. What?
Leave it to you to find a friggin' jungle in the middle of France.
Well, we're definitely headed in the right direction. Chateau should be this way. Not too far. Come on.
Yeah.
Not too far? With you, I never know if that means a quarter mile or 20. Like that time you got us lost in Peru?
Oh, you really want to bring up Peru?
You are not still holding that over me.
I was 15, Sully. Should have known when I met you that I'd be in prison within a year.
You were headed that way all on your own, if you recall. Besides, I got you out, didn't I? I always get you out.
Well, looks like we get to listen to Sully and Drake bicker here. And Chapter 6, the Chateau? That's what it was called, right? I already forgot. And in Uncharted 3, Drake's deception. One of my favorite things about this area is that you can really see how, okay, maybe in good lighting, but how high quality the texture detail is in this game. And apparently that's been because of there's a method that what you aim at does not get blurred out, but everything else in the game does, so it doesn't have to render everything out all at once like that. And it makes for really beautiful scenery when you're looking at it. I don't know what it looks like when you're not, because, I mean, what does a tree look like when it falls and nobody's around to hear it? I don't know, maybe like finding a treasure in a random creek in the middle of France. Hooray! Or maybe somebody just dropped their cup when they were camping. One of the... like Drake finds one of those red soda cups and it's like, treasure!
Come on, through here.
Oh, gosh. Let's go ahead and look through here. Oh my gosh.
Just like in Lawrence's notes. Gotta have more faith in me, Sully.
What do you know? Interesting little thing. Looks like we
gotta
go.
Remember this ravine being on the map.
They must have just put that in.
I thought this guy had a gun for a second.
We'll find another way around.
The guns are so loud in this game. Huh. Alright, so it looks like we're making our way up here. And yeah, the guns are so loud in this game. I don't know what it is with it. Whoa. Oh my. This is...
I don't know, kid.
Oh?
You sure we're in the right place? This doesn't seem old enough to be a Crusader castle. It's more like Renaissance to me.
You haven't been reading my books again, have you, Sully? Now, Lawrence says the original castle was built in the 11th century. The rest was added on later.
Interesting. Oh, gosh. Come on, come on, come on. There you go, alley-oop. And, where are you, Sully? Are you okay? You made it? Okay, cool. Worried about you, man. All right. Come on. I don't know. Can he make these jumps? Yes, he can. All right, cool. Let's go across to here. And whoa. Hold on tight. Look at this old car.
Sully, your first car.
Oh, man. That's a 1927 Auburn.
Huh. Fancy. What's going on in here? Whoa. Maybe I should. Okay, yeah? I didn't die.
What's this, Mr. Wizard?
Lawn art.
Pretty tacky.
I love it.
Now, the knight who owned this castle, Lord Godfrey, returned from the Crusades in the 12th century. According to Lawrence, all that's left of the original castle is the square keep and the gardens. If Godfrey brought any secrets back from Arabia, that's where we're gonna find him.
Huh. Okay. Well, it looks like we already got stuff to climb up over here. Might as well just start. I love how he just instantly knows. Nope. Before we even think about trying the door, we're already jumping on top of the wall. Oh, I love it. It's just hilarious. Just like nobody else would have that deduction reasoning.
I don't want to cut myself.
Okay. Let's go ahead and... Oh, I guess we're going up here. All right. We're inside the castle.
Be right back.
All right. Just like, that's the Nathan Drake way of solving something. It's like, you gotta go to the fifth floor of the apartment, take the elevator. No, climb up the side of the building. Oh, gosh! Ow. Well, that's one way to interrupt the conversation.
Oh, that hurts.
Sure it does.
Hey, kid, up here.
Up here?
Change chef.
All right, back up. I'll shoot the lock off.
All right.
So that's the only thing you shoot off.
I said lock.
Oh, gosh. Well, there you go. Why is that one chained up and none of the
you
other
good?
Ones? Weird.
Okay, we gotta make our way through the chateau to the gardens. That's where we'll find the old keep. Oh man, look at this place.
Where are we going? I don't know. Oh, he's trying to move it. Grunt! Grunt!
No! Can't get it open, this damn beam's in the way.
Oh.
Yeah, we gotta get some leverage.
Darn you, beam!
There? Can try.
So we're getting up there, huh? Well, how are we gonna do that? We could possibly climb up. Nope, no, we can't. Maybe I can climb up this chain here? No?
Help me lift this up.
Oh, okay. Sully always got the answers. Is this a piano? Guess it is. No, I don't know. Oh, it's a dresser.
Do it.
Cool. All right, let's get up that thing.
Be careful up there.
Thanks.
Damn thing's rotten.
Oh boy.
Looks like those chandeliers are on some kind of pulley system.
Yeah.
Oh.
Must be how they lowered them down to clean them.
Are we serious? What is with this game so far and loving me hanging on chandeliers? It came out before the song did. It's Drake's hit new single. Oh, I'm gonna swing. All right. Oh, there you go. It's working. Yay.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Okay. Now what? We're gonna go back? Let's just try it. Let's pop down. And then I guess I gotta go back around again? And maybe I can jump off there or something crazy? Who knows? Let's just try to go around again. It's a little bizarre so far, but I don't mind. So yeah, I just can't hop through there. But let me try getting on the chandelier and then that one. And see where that gets us.
Watch it, that thing's coming out of the ceiling.
How do you make a jump like that, like, feasibly? I don't know. Well, just as much as to make that one. Alright, now we can move this beam.
Here we go.
Alright, moving it, moving it, moving it. Come on. Right. Yeah. Awesome. Can we plop down? Huh.
Is that a popcorn machine?
Looks like it. Maybe not. Oh, it's a little clock. Weird. All right, this is a creepy old house. It's very destroyed
okay,
as well.
We can find a way to that tower.
But now it has like more modern stuff in it. Odd. I guess it's sort of modern. Yeah, where are we going right now? Up here maybe? Okay, it'd be interesting to see this house in its heyday. Definitely, unless this is its heyday, then I'm a little concerned. It used to look worse at some point. Oh, look at the flowers though. Life makes its way through in all situations. It's beautiful, Sully, but you don't care. You're just gonna keep running. Did you run through whatever this is? Fine then. If you're just gonna be a ghost all of a sudden, you're not dead yet. You're old, but you're not dead. What's going on? The light here is beautiful. I love that.
Hey, Nate. Square tower. Looks pretty old.
Yeah. That matches the one in Lawrence's notebook. That must be it. Nice.
Thanks.
Okay. Let's go through there and try to make our way. How do we do that? Well, there's nothing really here. This is a big old castle, though. I love it. Oh, there we go. There's an open window over here. Might as well slip on through. And plop. And this is new, too. But it doesn't look like there's anything here, unless we're out going through here.
Looks like we can get through here.
Yeah?
Yep. Come on.
Ooh, come on. You got it. This doggy crawl. Whoa.
Oh, thanks.
Well, we're still. I feel like we're just gonna go in a big circle here in a moment, but what is going on here? I guess I'm going this way?
Hey, Nate. Isn't this the same symbol that was on the tower?
Yeah. That's gotta mean something, right?
Maybe a secret passage?
In a fireplace? Kinda on the nose, don't you think?
Yeah, too simple.
Okay. Well, interesting. What does that mean? I think it has something to do with these guys because we walk up and they have an option. So why don't we check our little book? Are we allowed to? Yeah, we can. Is there any information though? Not looking like it. The sun sort of in our view here. Oh my. Hold on. Yeah, I know. I will in a second. As iron sharpens iron, so a friend sharpens a friend. Interesting. They call me Silver Fox. What does that mean? Who knows? None of this. Alright, so maybe we'll get to more of this information later, but I don't think any of it helped us at the moment for a good reason. Sully wanted me to check out this one specifically, so what do you got for me, Sully? Like, what does this do? Maybe it's not like there's a clue to it. Maybe we just need them all to face the correct direction? That's what I just checked. Karen, let me just go ahead and do that. But, okay. Oh, now it just brings me to the right page.
Four knights with an axe, a shield, a sword, and a morning star. Just like the ones in this room.
All right, so the shield faces the axe faces the shield. The mace faces the axe, and the sword faces the axe. So,
we gotta turn each knight so it's facing the right way.
Yeah.
What's the right way?
It's not that hard to figure out, man. You just gotta turn this one so that it's over there, because that one's the axe. Then the axe faces the shield. Yep, they just intermingle. They're like, hey, how you doing? So let's go ahead. And so while the axe is, you know, facing the shield and stuff, the main, oh, that was it. Whoops. Okay, I wasn't finished solving it, but I guess that's okay. It.
I'll push, you pull. On three, ready?
Wait, 1, 2, pull, or 1, 2, 3, pull?
Just pull.
Got it.
Oh my gosh. Whoa! Ow! Yikes.
Nate? Hey, you alright?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll live.
Oh my.
There's no way I'm getting back up there. I'm gonna head this way. Just meet me on the other side.
You got it. You be careful down there.
Right. Hope there is another side.
Okay then, let's go through. Now I probably have already put an arachnophobia warning on this episode, but if you are arachnophobic, I'm gonna give you a second warning here. Do not watch this part. Okay? Okay. All right, I'll probably put an annotation so you know when to skip, but you would have already seen it already. Oh boy, come on. Nasty. Nasty. Ah, oh, they're huge. Yikes, it gives me the tinglies. All right, let's dive. Come on, where are we going? We're going under here. You don't swim much in Uncharted games, so this is cool. Oh, come on. Pop back out now. All right, where are we going now? Oh, geez, this is sort of scary. I don't know where I'm going. Looks like through here. That seems to be it. Those spiders were gigantic. Disgusting. Hold on. Now we're slowly pushing through this really deep water. And it's nice and clear, too. That's nice. Wonder if it's warm. Whoa. Oh.
That's a good sign.
Okay. Interesting. Maybe I can get across here. I'm, like, soaking wet right now. My jeans are gonna shrink, and I won't be able to take them off. Oh, gosh. Yeah, let's get up here. And then... Oh, no, no. Come on. No, what are you doing? There. Jeez.
Way out.
I know, right, man?
Right, I should be able to climb up through there.
Are you sure about that? Oh, like that. Whoa, come on, go. This rock is as brittle as brittle things. Yeah, what the heck?
Oh, crap.
The bad guys are here.
They're here somewhere. Hunt them down.
Oh my, how did they know? I guess our car?
I warned Sully.
Well? One thing you could do is snag this guy. Oh man, this is not good. Let's go for it. Okay, who can I take out here first? Ready? Boop. And then, boop. Oh no, come on, take him out. Maybe that wasn't a good idea, but hey, we got 20 headshots, which is pretty cool. Ready? Oh, got rid of you. What, seriously? Okay, I really am not a fan of this gun. It just, really, buddy? Okay, I'm totally gonna die here. That is beyond stupid. Nobody, well. I'm joining my friend I threw down here, but that was just dumb. Well, if you can't beat him, hide from him. Let's try to get across to here. Maybe I can take this dude out, but he is in a precarious area. Now I can get up here. Is there anybody up here? Not yet. All right. Don't we have like walkie-talkies or something we can use to talk to Sully? Huh. What's going on over here? Maybe I can climb up here now? I can. I don't know if I'm supposed to be doing this right now, but it's what I've done. Huh. From up here, I do have a better advantage to take guys out, though, so that's great. Come on now. Oh, nope, that wasn't good because I missed every single shot because this weapon's horrible. There you go. It doesn't have enough range. It's super weird. It's like a short-range weapon. Come on, get you. Got one person there, and I'm about out of ammo, though, so that's not pleasant. Luckily, these guys really aren't getting up here anytime soon. Oh boy. And that wasn't enough to take you out, huh? Wasn't enough? Okay, now I'm out of ammo, so this is where things get bad. Luckily, I've taken out of like one or two guys, so hopefully I can just sort of keep working on it. Like, I can punch you out here. Come on, make it quick, because he has, whoa, that was so cool. All right, come on. Missed every single shot. Hi. Oh geez, you have that, yeah, I'm gonna take it. Maybe that wasn't worth it, but we're gonna find out one way or another. Oh boy, where are these dudes at? All right, so I don't have any ammo for that, but
Hopefully I won't need it. But these guys are running around like maniacs. None of them are actually close to me right now. But now you are, and now you are. Pick up that, and then run over here. Where are the other bad guys? It looks like we got more going on over here. Hey. Boom. Gotcha. Picked up more ammo there. Come on. There you go. Now I got more cold ammo. Cool. Whoa. What was that? I guess that was a car continuing to explode. Come on now. The guns are different. They're sincerely different. This is an AK. It doesn't feel anything like an AK does in other Uncharted games. Come on, pop back out. There are guys everywhere though. We're really tearing them up. So that's good to know. Oh boy. Oh, let me get this. And then let's get this. What, the arm micro is interesting. I don't mind it. Okay, buddy. Speaking of which, let's give it a try here. There you go.
Jesus. Small arm.
Oh boy. Where are you now? You're through the window, huh? Oh geez, they're just everywhere. Oh geez. Come on. Gotcha, nice. That looks to be about all of them for now. Yeah, let's get through here. And maybe we could climb up there now that we've taken those guys out. Nice. Oh. Come on now. Gotcha. Got that shotgun. Nice.
Thanks for the gift, boys.
Oh, great. Ooh. All right, then grenades. And then, boop. Nice. Let's pick up a few more grenades just in case some dudes pop up. But that's all we got for it. So let's plot down here. And what are these? More AKs? I'll take it. Okay, I'll take the AK. It'll be more worth it. This sawed-off shotgun really hasn't been working out too well. Yeah, let's go for the arc here. It's made perfectly for it. And then I'll take care of both of them. And then I'll close that in. Nice. Let's fit on through. All right. Ooh. You can see the seams in his shirt. That is so cool. All right, where are these dudes at? Oh my. Oh, there's Sully. Okay, let's help Sully out right now. Come on, take you down. Let's get the AK out, it's gonna be more accurate. Come on, leave Sully alone. He's a good guy. I don't care what you say. Get you. There you go. Oh my, that's not good. Hey, get you too. I remember dying a lot in this section too, so hopefully that doesn't really happen to us, but it might. Come on, take you out. No, I said take you out. We got another grenade here, which I might use on like to somebody, anybody really. Oh, they found me. Come on now. Oh, okay. Thank you for the free ammo. Actually, no, you can keep it. I hate that gun all of a sudden. It's not fun. All right, I'm picking up the worst guns right now. All right, let's sneak on over. And then, or not here, just kick him. Right in the face, right between the eyes. Seems to be everybody for right now. We gotta keep making our way through here though. Got more ammo. Oh, get it, nice. Whoa, was that Sully? What a shot from him. All right. There they are. Gotcha, yikes, insane. Oh, no, boom. The melee has gotten so diverse, I love it. All right. Get that one, and then let's run up here. Oh, come on, get you, at the least. Oh my gosh, did you just give him, oh my gosh. Well, that's one dude with a grenade we don't have to worry about anymore. As gruesome as that is, I think we just made him drop a grenade. Yes, we did, on top of another dude at that. Come on. Oh, thank you for the gun, mate. Oh, where are they now? Why are there so many? Come on, pop back up. Ready? Pop goes to Weasel, huh? Oh, yeah, nice. All right. Oh, hey, you wanna mess with me, huh? Well, there you go, you got some. Oh, and it dramatically falls off. Oh. All right, got him too. They're falling fast though, I can tell you that much. I think that was Sully over there. Yep. All right, cool. Now, where are we off to? Yeah, looks like this one. There you are. Yeah, victory.
All right. Well, which way now?
Oddly serene.
Not really sure.
Why don't we try going down?
Okay. We'll do that. Oh, geez, are we circling around? No, we're not.
Hey, Look at this.
Whoa.
What the hell? It's one of Talbot's men.
It was. But that's impossible. They just got here.
Yeah, but what could have happened to him?
I have no idea, but I sure as hell don't like it.
Huh. Maybe he looked like that before he died. Maybe he was just a prune face. Maybe he's a zombie. No, we already dealt with zombies in this game. Oh gosh, we're in this game series. What is this? Oh my.
Hey, the tile's depressed when you step on it. I'll stand over here so I don't step on any by accident.
Good idea.
All right. What does this do? Let's go ahead and check out our little book here. There we go. Interesting. So this is the pattern. We need, we start in the little sun. We gotta go through four chairs without a back. Then we got four X's, four chairs with the back on the wrong part of it. Two more X's and then four without back, or three. All right, so 4-3-4-2-3. All right, so we need to find that path now. So 1-2-3-4, like, okay, 1-2-3-4. 1-2-3-4, nope. 1-2-3-4. No. 1-2. Yeah, 1-2-3-4.
Maybe you gotta walk across them in a certain order.
Yeah! I know that much already. So let's just try it. 1-2-3-4. 1-2. That's. Oh, wait. It might, though. 3-4. 1. What? Was that wrong?
It's gonna take long.
Oh, it's just three.
I'm doing my best, Sully.
All right, let's try this one more time. Okay. 1-2-3-4. 1-2-3. And then pull this out again. Now it's 4 and then 2 and then, 3. All right. 1-2-3-4. 1-2. Wait, just 2, right? Just 2. And then 1-2-3. Yeah, we did it! Hooray! Problem solved! Awesome.
It's pitch dark in here. Wanna give us some light?
Sure. All right, help us out, Sully. Come on, you can do it, buddy. Get that light, or not. What are you, how are you gonna light stuff up for me? Whoa. It's spooky.
Hey, a little more light, Sully.
Yeah, you got it. You keep saying this, but I don't see any light. Sully, pick up the pace, or I'll put a gun on you. Okay. Oh my.
Seems to be an alchemist lab.
Something like that. Wait, interesting.
Does this place remind you of anything?
Yeah. Marlowe's creepy hideout, now that you mention it.
Sully. Sully, this is John Dee's lab.
All the way out here? In France?
Well, he must have traced the clues back to the Crusades, just like Lawrence did.
Huh. Wow.
Hey, look at this.
Yeah, I'm looking at it. What about it? Oh, am I supposed to? There you go.
Sabian script again. But what are these symbols? Looks like he was trying to work something out. There's some sort of message written here in Anakian script.
What is with all these scripts? What do they mean? I don't know.
Think you
What's my line
it?
Again?
I'll Maybe. Try.
Use the cipher desk. Okay, cool. Ooh, something new.
The altar guards the entrance to the underworld. Huh.
Well, we did so
much.
Well, he
did use magic to conjure spirits.
Yeah, or the altar could be hiding a secret passage.
Oh, right.
Help me push.
All right, let's go ahead and push. Nope, come on, push. I gotta tap it. All right, push, push, push. Yay!
Look at that.
Crafty old bastard.
Why, thank you.
All right. Oh gosh, I hope there's no spiders in this one too. All right.
Oh, here we go.
Oh.
Sully, give me a light.
Yeah.
Always with the lighting. Yay.
Ah, much better.
You know, one of these days you're really gonna have to start carrying your own matches.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, what is he talking about? Let's go down here. Okay.
Whoa. Ooh. Looks like they really wanted to keep something out.
We're in. Here, give me a hand with this.
Yeah. He seems to got it himself, but okay. Don't get a splinter.
I got it. There you go.
Big old door. Wow. There must weigh a ton.
Looks like the family crypt. Your pal Godfrey must be down here then, huh?
With any luck. If he knew anything about the Atlantis of the Sands, he took it with him to the grave.
So let's find the grave.
Exactly.
So it looks like we're getting puzzle after puzzle
like
at this point.
He was trying to solve this, but he never quite finished.
Sabian script again. Horse. Scraps of paper found in John D's secret lab in France. So this is what we just picked up. Interesting. Huh. I seen. I have no clue. Let's fiddle with some stuff. What'll this do?
Medieval game show? Pretty elaborate.
Yeah.
Aha!
He doesn't seem to be in any of these crypts.
No. Now they would have hidden his tomb. Keep looking around.
Let's do that really quick. Can I get out of here? I'm pressing buttons to get out. There you go. So the bird is going to be next to the 8, the 17, and the double X. All right, bird, where's the 8, where's the 7? Oh, there it is, it's right here. Now, what kind of context clues that answers for the rest of these, I have no clue. But for right now, we got that figured out. Maybe there's some more we can find. Okay, so the horse is going to be 2 spaces over and 1 space up from the bird. So let's go ahead and change this to the horse, that's what I wanted. Right, no, I need the Up and Adams horse, right? I think so, no, that's a tiger. I need the Up and Adams horse. I think, I hope so. That's gonna be like this. I wanna hope. Let's check it out. That was the right horse, but was that all? From what I've seen, because I have no clue what else we do here. Maybe there's some context clues around the room. All right, so we see the bird here, but oh my, this one's sort of torn up, it's empty. Huh, now what's going on over here? Here we got the horse again. Oh, look at this. There's the 17 again. Isn't that a name of a movie? And this one's all cleared up. Oh, you can sort of just barely see it's the horse. So, is this what it's on top of? Okay, that's on top of a fork, right? But not really. Okay, so the yeehaw horsey, that's a lion. That's the problem. So let's see. This is the bird. And then this is the 8. So maybe it's what's to the left of it? Because obviously the 8 is, it's weird how it just like sort of works, but also, but no, it changes depending on where we're standing. So to the left of it would be the 8. Above it would be the double X. So now we got all the context clues we need for which one goes where. With that being said, under it is the 17. To the left of it is the squiggle squog. And then, I can't see this one really. And then something. Okay, so 17, squiggle squog. Where's that for the lion? All right, so yeah, let's change to the lion here, and the 17, and then the squiggle squag. There are multiple 17s. Ah, okay, well, this is the one we need, I believe. All right, so now the horse is very clearly here, and we got like a circle, a backwards C, a fork. As long as you have like 2 of them, I think we'll be fine. All right, so this will be the last one we need to solve here, and I think we got it. All right, move it. Move it. Move it. Alright, so where is there a C and a fork? It's right over here. And that answer, it did! Sweet, that wasn't too bad at all.
Good job, kid.
Alright, let's sneak on in.
Inviting. Watch yourself.
maybe John D was really short.
I presume? The one and only.
Wow. Interesting.
This is it. Here, hold this, will you?
Sure.
Oh my.
Look, it's some sort of amulet. There's something written here.
Gonna do this right on top of Lancelot, huh?
Uh-huh. It's in Sabine script.
Well, that'd be from ancient Yemen, all right?
Yeah, exactly where Francis Drake would have landed back in the 16th century. Could be the name of a city?
Yeah, from 3,000 years ago. Without the rest of that inscription, we still don't know where to look.
Well, let's hope the other half is in Syria.
Yeah, and the Cutter and Chloe can find it.
Hopefully. Now we can say goodbye to you. Thank you, Dead Kai. I hope you are okay with us stealing your stuff. There's no way we won't be running into bad guys on our way back. Let's hobble on a crawl through the crab walk.